The if function in Excel is a useful function with a simple concept. It allows you to evaluate a statement and return one value if that statement is true, and another value if it's false. Here's an example of how it works. At this hardware store, customers may request delivery of the items they've purchased for an extra fee of 40 euros. So if the customer requests delivery, we want the cashier to select Yes from this dropdown in cell C19, and then cell D19 will display that value of 40 euros, and it'll be added to the bill. If the cashier selects No, we want cell D19 to display N/A. Here's how we represent that. We start with equals and the function name if, open parentheses. And what's our logical test? What statement do we want to evaluate? We want to know if the value of cell C19 is equal to yes. So let's type that. We type our yes in double quotes because it's text. We type a comma to indicate that we're done entering our logical test. And if it is true, what should Excel display? We want it to display 40. This cell is already formatted to display numbers as euros, so we don't need to type that euro symbol in front of the number 40. What about this argument, value if false? That is, what should Excel do if cell C19 doesn't say yes? We want it to say N/A, so we type that in double quotes. We close parentheses and enter. So if the customer does not request delivery, no delivery fee. But if they do, 40 euros. Notice that for the if function, both the second and third arguments are in square brackets. This means that they're optional. However, in the case of this if function, at least one of these two optional arguments must be provided so that Excel knows what you want to do. If you only provide a value if true, but the logical test is false, then Excel will display the word false. If you only provide a value if false, but the statement is true, then Excel will display a zero. Nesting a function means using one function as the argument of another function. The if function in Excel can be nested when you have multiple conditions to meet. To do this, we replace the false value by adding another if function to make a further test. In our example, let's say that at this hardware store, when the subtotal is over 500 euros, the delivery fee is automatically waived. So let's include that in the logic of an if function by nesting. We type equals if, open parentheses. So we want to say if D18 is greater than 500, that's the logical test, comma. What do we want to see in this cell if the subtotal is more than 500 euros? Maybe we want to see the words fee waived. Let's type that in double quotes. Then we type a comma, and Excel wants to know, well, what if the subtotal isn't more than 500 euros? What do you want me to do then? Well, two things really, and this is where we start nesting another if function. If cell C19, that's this yes or no cell, says yes, so let's type if open parentheses, C19 is equal to the word yes, double quotes, then I want you to add 40 euros to the bill. So we type our 40 here. But if cell C19 is not yes, then what do we want it to do? We just want it to display N/A. We close parentheses, but we had two open, so let's add another. So our existing bill is 385.83 before taxes, and our customer did request delivery. So we've got that 40 euros added to the bill, as expected. Let's select No, no delivery. The 40 euro charge is removed, and we see N/A instead. Perfect. But let's make this bill over 500 euros. Let's add 200 euros to this bill. The text in D19 changes to fee waived. So even though this customer didn't request delivery, maybe we want to say to this customer, hey, we're offering free delivery on your order. Would you like to take it? Yes. We change this no to yes, and the display stays the same, fee waived. Kind of cool, right? To learn more about the if function, watch our videos on nesting the if function with the and or function for even more tricks. To simplify more complex conditions into just one formula, you might want to explore our resources on the COUNTIF, SUMIF, and VLOOKUP functions.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.